Cheese! I have cheese in my fridge, you have cheese in your fridge. Cheese is probably the thing holding reality together. I'm a bit sick, so I'm not enthusiastic at all. But today I'm building cheese. Let's name this cheese. So it's not gonna be that massive. We're probably gonna make something like that. Actually, it'll need to be a bit bigger. That should be good. And we can probably go to the second floor. However, because this house is technically cheese, we're gonna have to have a couple holes in place. Because otherwise, how are you gonna know? It's just a weird triangle. And the coloring is very simple. Everything is yellow. Now we can hopefully do like a driveway. So I'm just hoping we can kind of ease in. Actually, it looks kind of bad when it's just a floor, so we're gonna make it out of a roof so that it's raised a tiny bit. Now it's on the level of the pavement, and it's just like a tiny rise off the ground, but I think it makes a big difference. Now this is gonna be one sorry garage. In fact, it's so small, it might not even be a garage at this point, so we're just gonna get a bike. And I absolutely love that I made these sides unequal, because now it's almost impossible to floor this thing.
Flooring a triangle, flooring a triangle.
Now the door has to be cheese too. Why is this door bigger than the garage? So then we can probably put this door, color it all cheese. And before we get on to doing the inside, I actually want to do a bit of gardening. So first, we need a bit of dirt. How am I forgetting where the dirt texture is? Would it be fun if we made the wall out of cheese? That's exactly what we're gonna do. This is just uncanny. Yeah, I am not comfortable. It would be very uncanny if we made the bushes like cheese. However, this is a cheese house, so we might as well do it.
Placing down the bushes.
Now, I think it's common knowledge that cheese is a modern thing. It's because cheese was invented in 1997. So we're gonna add that modernity with these LED cheese lights. Actually, technically, wouldn't these be cheese strips?
Placing down the cheese strips.
This may as well just be a one-color house challenge. Okay, then we can't forget to add a cheesy doorbell for the cheesy guests. Okay, now heading inside, what type of stairs would a cheese have? I'm feeling like these suspended stairs are very cheesy. I just want to say that the inside isn't gonna be cheese. For the windows, we can't use any normal windows. Instead, we have to use these round openings as cheese holes, because otherwise it's not a cheese without holes. As you can probably tell, this house is very secure and no one can possibly ever break in. Okay, so currently the strategy is to place these small holes and then to resize them later on. Okay, this is cheesy enough. Now I think it's time for the interior. I'm not a good builder by any means. Now I think the downstairs can be mostly open plan, but the upstairs, this thing is gonna be more divided. So here's the main layout. Bedroom, bathroom. I think I'll start with the kitchen.
Epic kitchen montage. I am honestly too good. Bloxburg developers, hire me right now.
We're gonna do the Reese's strategy. Wherever there's not enough lighting, we're just gonna put something in the basement. Beautiful. Okay, now it's time for the appliances. So we're gonna have a fridge, a microwave, the open source 3D modeling app, a couple plants, never make anything bad. Cheese! Okay, so the kitchen is pretty much done. Now I think it's time to move on to the living area. So we can probably add a console. Now we can put a massive TV.
Not me building an absolutely delightful living space. I'm being literal, this thing sucks.
Okay, now I think we can make this area a little office. And I realized that this office desk actually looks like one of those standing desks. I actually have one. Hold on, give me a minute. Okay, now I'm standing. We can probably use this iSlim computer.
12 and a half hours of sleeping later.
Okay, it's the next day. I've worked a bit, and I think it's time to continue the cheese house. So in this house, I want to be able to level up my skills, so I've made a little list. I have to have a computer, piano, at least one book, and that weird art painting thing. So I think we can replace this iSlim computer with this one. Okay, so I've done this little desk setup for now, and that's the computer down. Above it, we can probably have like a shelf or two, and here we can put some books, as well as a sleek metal stopper. Now, I think this would be the perfect space for a piano, because you're absolutely in the way of everything. I think we can put the piano underneath the stairs, so then it's not really in the way. That's the piano down and the books down, and we can probably put the painting stand just right over here. And with that, we can probably move on to the second floor.
Uncheesifying the walls.
Personally, I want to try something new. Now, something I've never done is make a contemporary house. I want to try and do that here. Oh my God, Bloxburg has become so glitchy ever since these new developers came around. Like, I'm not even coloring this window. Why is it blue? Coeptus was much less buggy. So we can probably work on the hallway first, and I think we should make the floor a bit darker. And maybe we could do the same on the bottom. So I'm gonna need a bit of inspiration, and Google probably isn't the place to go, so we're gonna have to open up Pinterest. So it's all very very, very basic. In fact, it looks like they don't even have wall trims on the top.
Copying, I mean building a custom bench out of basic shapes.
And for the fence, we can probably use the sleek glass railing, just because it's not intrusive at all, and you can barely notice it. And they also have a plant, as well as some little built-in cabinets. And I want to use the pillars to make like a curved wall going into these custom cabinets.
In what way are these custom? They are literally the cheapest counters in the game.
I would die for these wooden planks. It looks so good. And then for the cabinets, they have these really cute tiny ones, just like this. And then I think we could use a basic shape to make a fake wall.
I am such a pro.
So we can do something like this, and then on the counter we can hopefully put another couple table lamps, and I actually think we could put a cutting board. And I've also added this LED light, so now it's like a little counter space where you can, I don't know, draw. Okay, as we can see in the picture, the doors are mostly like these tall window-like ones. And now we just have this really long wall here, so I'm thinking we could turn it into a gallery.
Not me wasting thousands of dollars to make custom shelves for no reason.
So I've done this little gallery hallway thing, and I want to pull a Reese's and do one of those realistic plants. This is my first time ever doing one of these plant decals, so wish me luck. Since when was it this difficult to find a good picture of a plant? Okay, so now we can move on to the master bedroom. I don't even think a double bed can fit in here. So this is going to be a lonely household with only one bed. We can probably make the bed stand out of a basic shape, and from what we see in the picture, it is extremely goofy. We can borrow one of these lamps, and we can probably have an alarm clock. We can also borrow this carpet, make it a bit bigger, so we can place a wardrobe around there. And we can probably add a fake wall using a basic shape, just so that the space doesn't feel too awkward.
I added a bunch of plants around the wardrobe, because that is the only way to save my horrible building.
We can add a neon strip to the top of this shelf, and we can line it with books, because you know whoever lives here is a big reader. And finally, over here, we could probably add a small desk, and we can probably give it like a iSlim laptop, as well as another one of these plants. Does this place have enough lights? No, it does not. So we can probably borrow one of these and then hang it above the desk. Okay, one bedroom down, and now it's time to move on to the second bedroom. Never hurts to copy and paste.
I forgot to speak while building this room.
How am I this bad at YouTubing?
And finally, it's time for the bathroom. And in this space, we can probably have a sink. And in fact, we can make these counters similar to those. Oh my god, Bloxburg, why do you keep glitching? Then we can probably add a little rug and probably a towel or two. Then we can add some electric toothbrushes and some lights. And now we can probably add a toilet around here. And once again, coming in with the fake wall. And I think that this place could be the shower. So we can probably have a plant. And as a final little detail, we can probably make not exactly a fence, but just a little separator for the shower so that the water from the shower doesn't go everywhere on the floor. And I think that's it for the house. So here is our wonderful cheese house. Oh wait, I have to change the decals. Give me a second. I think it's time for the epic tour. So first off, you have this long winding driveway, which leads you all the way to the majestic front entrance. As you enter through the sleek pivoting door, you're instantly greeted by a wonderful open plan living space. Okay, on a serious note, I feel like the bottom and the top feel as though they've been made by different people. So for the garage, we just have a little bicycle because, you know, we have to train our legs. Here's a little desk space where you can sit. Then you have a small living space. You can just watch TV while sitting on the couch. It is absolutely the most generic thing you've ever seen. Here's our little kitchen. I mean, I tried to do a farmhouse sink, but I think there are better ways to do it than this. And the kitchen itself is pretty simple. Then we have an elegant piano underneath our floating stairs. And the second floor is designed with a contemporary touch. So in the hallway, we have a small area to sit and relax. And here we just have some countertop space where you can be productive and draw and design the next iPhone. Right as you go up the stairs, you have the bathroom. Here's the small sink area with two toothbrushes and a wonderful arrangement of towels. Moving through, we have a toilet, which is specifically hidden from view, as well as a small shower place right next to nature. And this was specifically designed to have the ultimate privacy. No one can ever see you poop, and absolutely no one can see you shower. Moving through the corridor, we have a door on our right, which is the small kid bedroom. It is made up of the absolute necessities. So we have a wardrobe to get dressed, a TV for entertainment, and some books for education. And also, this was designed with the utmost thoughtfulness, because as you sleep, there is a high chance of rain pouring directly onto your head. And finally, we have the master bedroom. You enter into this wonderful quadrilateral space. Here you have a productivity setup with a laptop. Wait, since when could you close them? Then you have a nice and green wardrobe. And here we have our sleeping space. So right next to the bed, we also have an alarm clock as well as all these books. And overall, I'm pretty happy with the second floor. However, we don't talk about this. Thank you for watching me build the cheese. I'll catch you next time.